What's up everybody, I'm Ben with FallTech, and today I'm going to quickly explain the process of choosing a full body harness so when you do select one, you know that you made the best choice for your industry and application, and we're gonna do it in 5 simple steps. As you may have noticed at first glance, full body harnesses relatively look the same, so what I'm gonna do here is remove all the confusion by addressing different industries and applications and go through the different features and components of harnesses, including D-ring configurations, leg strap attachments, fitment and sizes, belted versus non-belted, durability, comfort, how much you should spend, and weighing the cost of ownership. So by the end of this video, you'll know exactly what you need and feel good about your harness choice. Plus, later on in this video, we'll go through a few quick scenarios on choosing a harness from entry level to premium harnesses, which will definitely help guide you toward that final selection. So stick around for that. Okay, so first and foremost, before we dive into all this, the very, very first thing you have to make sure of is, does the harness comply with ANSI Z359.11? This product compliance is the gold standard. This is not the first step in the video because it's something you must know about the product before the selection process. So how do you know you've got an ANSI compliant harness? If it is, you'll find the tag located on the harness under a protective cover or sewn on the webbing. But even though ANSI compliant may be written on the label, it may not actually be ANSI compliant. So to know for sure if a harness is ANSI compliant, you can ask the harness manufacturer for a declaration of conformity and test results. They are required to provide the DOC upon your request. So that's how you'll know you've got the real deal gold standard of an ANSI compliant product. Okay, so now that we got that out of the way, let's do this. Let's start with step one. The first thing you have to do is start with the type of business or industry you're in. Is it construction, general industry, energy and utility, oil and gas, distribution warehouse, rescue, etc.? Now, if you're tasked with choosing harnesses for your business or yourself, you'll need to know what the applications are and how often and for how long workers will be wearing a harness. Is it every day, all day, or rarely throughout a month or a year? It's important to acknowledge this because you've got to weigh the cost of ownership for choosing the right harness, and I'll cover this later on in the video. So knowing what you or the workers are doing is an important place to start because we'll know how they're tooled up. In other words, are they carrying a lot of weight or no tools at all? We need to know this because this is really where the path to choosing a harness begins. If you're tooling up, you're likely to go with a belted harness because if your application or trade doesn't require a lot of tools on your body, a non-belted harness is the route you'll take. Also, choosing a belted harness takes the strain off of your back by dispersing the load you're carrying on your hips. And it's much more convenient than wearing a traditional tool belt and a separate non-belted harness. Next, step two. Who is going to be using the harness? Will multiple people of varying sizes be sharing one harness, or does each person need a single individual size for a personal fit? Because comfort is important to the worker. These are things to think about. Harnesses are available in 3 types of fitments: Unifit, dual size, and individual sizes. Unifit is a one size fits all harness from small to XL, and it's typically seen on basic entry level, lower price, or multi-user shared harnesses because they're designed to fit a range of body sizes, and they're typically the least comfortable harness. It's really the harness to choose if you just want to be OSHA compliant for the lowest cost. Yeah. Dual size harnesses give you a better balance between fitment and comfort. With dual size, small, medium, or large, extra large options, you also get the comfort at a reasonable price. Individual or personal size harnesses cover each size from extra small to triple XL. Just like clothing, these harnesses are going to fit each person's body type and shape, resulting in more comfort with less excess webbing flopping around. Now, I do want to take a short detour here and mention how there is a sizing and fitment issue for women trade workers. The problem is, regardless if a woman is tall or short, narrow or curvy, they may often wear a small or medium harness that never seems to fit right. Let me give you a quick example. If a woman was a size small, but since she has accentuated curves, she's got to go up to a medium. The problem she faces now is that there's all this extra webbing to deal with. The whole thing just becomes an annoying, uncomfortable mess for her. So check this out. The experts at FallTech recognize this issue that women face with harness fitment and developed the FT1 Fit Harness, which for the very first time in the history of harnesses, has adjusters on the sub-pelvic strap to help dial in that customized fit, enabling a woman to wear her perfect, proper-sized harness. And with the horizontal leg strap design, it gives women even more added comfort. Moving on to the different parts and features, including D-rings, leg strap buckles, and hardware material. Starting with D-ring configurations number 3, which are an important feature to think about because where the D-rings are placed on the harness has a lot to do with the application or what the worker is doing while wearing the harness. Now, all harnesses have a dorsal D-ring located between the shoulder blades, which is primarily used for fall arrest, but you'll also see harnesses with 3 D-rings and sometimes 4 D-rings. Side or hip D-rings are exclusively for work positioning or restraint, where a worker is connected at the hip to position himself with whatever task he's got to do. Hip D-rings are never connected to a fall protection device, so these workers are still connected by the dorsal D-ring. Sternal D-rings in the center of the chest can be used instead of a dorsal D-ring, but are limited to some work applications, primarily with ascending and descending a ladder, and are limited to only 2 feet of free fall distance. The sternal D-ring is often used simultaneously with the dorsal D-ring, so both are connected to a device in confined space applications. Okay, moving on to leg strap buckles, number 4. There are 3 options available: mating buckles, tongue buckle, or quick connect buckles. For the most part, this option is going to be personal preference, and these options tend to be limited as you go up in harness quality. Entry-level basic harnesses tend to use, but are not limited to, mating buckles where one end slips inside the other. Tongue and buckle leg straps are found on entry-level harnesses all the way up to top premium harnesses. Quick connect buckles are often available for more higher-end premium individual size harnesses because these buckles allow the user to dial into that perfect personal fit that is unique to them. There may be practical reasons for choosing mating or tongue buckle straps over quick connect straps. For example, when workers have to share a harness, which is common, or workers in really cold weather might remove layers of clothing later on in the day as it warms up. Before I get into hardware material, I want to talk a bit more about leg straps, which, you know, are notoriously uncomfortable because the straps go just right up through the groin. To eliminate the pain and discomfort that workers have endured for decades, FallTech developed comfort legs, which are leg straps that wrap laterally around the thigh, which don't create that V shape, causing all this annoyance and irritation throughout the day. But are these horizontal leg straps just as safe during a fall arrest event as conventional straps? This is an important question. The answer is yes. These straps have been designed and tested to work when they are properly worn snug around the leg. It's actually loose fitting straps that, in the event of a fall, may cause extreme injuries to the groin. So check out the harnesses available with comfort legs at falltech.com. Okay, now let's get back to hardware material. For D-rings, buckles, and torso adjusters, these are going to be made of either steel or aluminum. With steel hardware, you're either gonna be seeing stamped steel or forged steel. Now, I'm not gonna get into the weeds here with the chemistry for each of these, but forged is a higher quality steel that is more resistant to corrosion when compared to stamped steel, but both work great. Aluminum hardware, as you know, is lighter than steel and is available on some mid-level harnesses and definitely with premium harnesses. Now, before I get into the last step here, I want to quickly give you an idea of what to really expect from entry-level, mid-level, and premium harnesses so you have a better knowledge of what makes one harness better than another. For entry-level harnesses, you're going to see basic hardware components, no padding, and unifit or dual size. This is a harness for when comfort doesn't matter and your budget is low. Mid-level harnesses usually have more padding, maybe aluminum hardware or forged steel, and better fitment with either a dual size or individual size, so you get more comfort here. Also, mid-level harnesses have more available options for specific applications. Premium harnesses are obviously going to give you even more components and features that increase comfort, tougher material for added durability and longevity, higher weight carrying capacity, gel padding, ergonomic design for personal adjustment and fit, ventilation, lighter weight, a toothpick, scissors, and a bottle opener. Okay. Not the last three, but you get the idea that these harnesses are designed and built to do a lot more. All right, so we've covered pretty much everything you're going to come across from the majority of harnesses, but there are still a few things to consider when choosing a harness. Even though we've gone through the features and benefits, you might still ask yourself, what do I really need? And this brings us to the last step, number 5, with choosing a harness. which is weighing the cost or lowering the cost of ownership. In other words, we want to know what the long-term value or costs involved are. So to lower the cost of ownership with a harness, we can look at a few things like upfront investment, durability, and intelligent design. Think about how a superior fitting harness that's comfortable to wear allows a worker to be more productive because they're less likely to endure physical annoyances, pain, or fatigue throughout the day. Now, if you have multiple workers who are constantly taking time to fiddle with their harness to relieve discomfort, imagine just five workers having to spend 20 minutes per day throughout the day to adjust their discomfort. This adds up to over 8 hours of lost working time in a week. I mean, imagine like a whole job. Another thing to point out here is a comfortable employee can be a safer employee. And that safe employee helps to keep a business's risk profile low. So guys who don't want to wear a harness or don't wear correctly because they're uncomfortable can exponentially increase the chances of having the business's experience modification rating or mod rate go up. And a higher rating can have a catastrophic impact on a business. So having a safe employee creates less incidences. Less incidences leads to a lower EMR. A lower EMR provides lower insurance premiums, which provides better access for bidding on jobs. The next thing to think about when weighing the cost of ownership is an easy one: durability. You know that higher quality materials tend to last longer, which inevitably improves the service life of a harness. How often you will need to replace a harness is important to consider. Certain applications are going to wear out a harness quicker, which is why intelligent designs built into a harness can increase its life and therefore result in fewer replacements and lower total costs. You can see great examples of intelligent designs on the FallTech FT Iron harness, which features a wear pad on the subpelvic strap or the abrasion resistant shoulder panels with gel pads padding on the FT1 harness. Both features increase the life of a harness compared to traditional harnesses. These are intelligent designs. And if I can go back to the comfort part for a sec here, check this out. The AeroGrip D-ring plate on both of these harnesses have arrow-shaped slots to reduce the chances of the D-ring plate slipping down, especially when wearing personal SRLs. And when the D-ring plate slips down, it's known to put a lot of strain on a worker's back. The shoulder yoke on the FT1 has a neoprene neck guard to reduce neck irritation, especially when having to, you know, reach up. It's just the worst. The FT1 harness has so much more, including the adjustable tool belt slots that enable you to customize the placement of your tool bags, ventilation in the waist pad, gel padding, tool tether anchors, upgraded lanyard keepers, and an upgraded SRL attachment point for a quick and easy SRL connection. And you can't forget the comfort legs leg straps that go around the thigh and away from the groin. And there's also a non-belted version. There's just nothing better than this. This harness is beyond premium. All right, so now that you know what your general options are and how to weigh the cost of ownership, let's run through a few quick scenarios for different industries and choose a harness. Let's start with a couple general industry examples, such as warehousing or transportation, where workers are picking inventory. This is a price-driven decision because even though these guys are wearing a harness for most of the day, they're probably driving a personal lift and just grabbing boxes. And the same would be true for someone in a maintenance role who's just going to wear it when it's necessary. So a low-price unifit harness like the Contractor Series by FallTech is a great example for an entry-level harness to choose. However, construction workers who carry more tools and tougher conditions, they need that upgrade to a mid-level or even a premium harness that has more padding and more weight-carrying capacity. Plus, a single-size fitment provides added comfort. You could also lower the cost of ownership by having one better-built mid-level harness rather than replacing three lower-level. Also, for construction workers such as scaffolders or framers, a harness from the Tradesman Plus series or Journeyman Flex Aluminum series by FallTech are great examples for the next level up from entry level. The Tradesman Plus is a dual size harness and we're starting to see some padding, which gets us more into comfort now. There is a Journeyman Flex Steel series and Journeyman Flex Aluminum, making it lighter, and both feature better padding and better hip or cam adjusters. There are much more configurations when compared to the Tradesman Plus series. Okay, let's look at the oil and gas industry now and see what would be best for rig workers who do maintenance and repairs and refineries working on turnaround or outage. These guys are heavily focused on productivity and doing high intensity work for long periods of time. So they need a harness that is extremely durable and will perform so well that it can keep up with the worker. The cost of ownership here is extremely important because the harness must not slow the worker down. So to eliminate downtime, a top premium harness is absolutely going to be worth the investment. And the pinnacle of premium harnesses is, you guessed it, the FT1.
Yeah!
All right, by now you should be able to master how to choose a harness for nearly every application. I encourage you to see all the in-house FallTech brand styles and features available to you at falltech.com. Take a look around. And if you're still not sure on what your final decision should be, our sales team is happy to reach out to you and help you choose the best options available to you for what you need. And you can locate a regional sales manager on the FallTech website. Let us know in the comments below what you think of the FT1 harness and the FT1 fit with the hip adjusters and the new Comfort Legs leg straps. And as always, please ring that bell icon so you get notified when we post new videos. Subscribe because you love this information and give it a thumbs up because you learned something. All right, I will see you in the next one.